Wolverine wouldn't look like Wolverine without his signature claws. They're real snapped! But he wouldn't have these without his original mutant ability, a superhuman healing factor that allowed him to survive an incredibly invasive adamantium graft job. But Wolverine also wouldn't look like Wolverine unless he was totally jacked, bro. So if his power is to repair cells and make new ones in response to damage, wouldn't any exercise routine quickly turn Wolverine into the ultimate bodybuilder? Oh, yeah, come on. Today's question comes from LukeHaas22 on Instagram, and I love it because it plays into our assumptions about fitness and how our bodies work. You've probably heard from someone who eats kale that getting bigger muscles means damaging those muscles more, like lifting weights to tear muscle tissue, which then grows back bigger and stronger. But if repairing damage is what makes big muscles, wouldn't Wolverine put on muscle faster and easier than any human? First, you have three different kinds of muscle tissue in your body. Cardiac, which you can find in your heart, smooth, which you can find in the hollow visceral organs of your body, like your stomach, and skeletal muscle. Now that is the muscle that we can work out and make bigger, and your body has around 640 of those muscles, the biggest of which is the old glutey max back here, and the smallest of which is the stapedius muscle, which is as long as these blades are thick, just a millimeter. And it's right here in your inner, oh, I'm tank. No matter how big or how small skeletal muscle is, it gets its strength from its structure. Inside of a skeletal muscle are bundles of muscle cells. And inside each muscle cell is a bundle of so-called myofibrils. And inside of those bundles of myofibrils are bundles of myofilaments. Now, when the body wants a muscle to move, a neuron signals it to through a lot of complicated chemistry, and these long protein chains of myofilaments move past each other and contract, which contracts the myofibrils, which contracts the muscle cells, which contracts the muscle as a whole. Now, by bundling like this, skeletal muscle can generate a lot of force in not a lot of cross-sectional area, which is good for Wolverine because canonically, he's just 5'3". Yeah, okay, calm down, dude. You're short, all right? Stay in your pants. Wolverine's healing factor is more or less the ability to repair and replace tissue. But getting yoked, bro, is not about creating more muscle cells. Shortly after you were born, your muscle cells mature and become postmeiotic, meaning that they no longer undergo mitosis, they no longer divide. So for example, if I was to take a muscle biopsy from someone like me, and from an expert bodybuilder, oh yeah, come on, you would find the same number of muscle cells, proportionally speaking. Cells don't divide to make muscles bigger. Instead, the number of muscle cells stays the same and the cell size gets bigger. That doesn't sound like snicked at all, does it? I mean, misleading onomatopoeia! The biological mechanism through which one becomes a brolossus is called muscle hypertrophy. Very generally speaking, muscle hypertrophy, getting bigger muscle cells, occurs when your muscles are adding more protein to themselves than they are removing. This is the process of adding more of those protein chains, which increases the diameter of the cells themselves, thereby increasing the size of the muscle. Oh yeah, come on, it's good. Keep it going. Come on, one more, two more, nice. Let's go get coffee. We haven't yet established what makes muscle hypertrophy happen. The body is really complicated, but we know it has to be some combination of hormones, of the immune system, of growth factors, of genetics, and of exercise. And exercise is what is popularly associated with tissue damage. Now, when we work out, it's over 1,000 kilograms. When we work out, there is tiny microscopic damage done to our muscle fibers. And when muscle fibers are damaged, the body activates a legion of dormant satellite cells, and these satellite cells move to the location of the injury and then donate their own genetic material to the muscle cells. These muscle cells then use that material to synthesize more protein to repair the injury and make the muscle cells themselves bigger and more able to handle the stress of working out. In theory, Wolverine would be better at this. However, because skeletal muscle cells don't divide, there is a limit on how much they can regenerate. When a muscle cell is damaged enough to die, other muscle cells don't divide to replace it like Wolverine's skin cells would do if he got a really bad cut. No, instead, that muscle tissue is just replaced with scar tissue, which does not function as well, which is why in a really bad muscle injury, there is permanent loss of muscle strength. Ow. So the relationship between muscle damage and muscle hypertrophy is complicated. Damage and Wolverine's superhuman ability to recover from it may not even matter. I already cut myself with these things right in between, I punctured in between my knuckles. It hurt every time, which was once, but it hurt. Because growing more muscle cells isn't how swole works, to become the ultimate bodybuilder, Wolverine would want there to be a direct relationship between muscle growth and muscle damage. That is to say, the more you damage the muscles, the more they regenerate and the bigger and stronger muscles that you get. But we already know this isn't true. Think about it. Who has the biggest muscles among athletes, the humans who are really good at putting on muscle? Well, it's bodybuilders who use resistance training, like Arnold. And who has the smallest muscles among athletes? Well, it's endurance trainers, like marathon runners. Now, which kind of training do you think causes more muscle damage? Well, you may be surprised to learn that it is in fact endurance training. Running many, many kilometers is a lot more damaging to your muscles than lifting a couple of kilograms a few times a week. That changes this relationship from one that is potentially direct to one that is inverse, meaning that more muscle damage is actually related to less muscle growth. Now, we don't know why this is the case exactly, but one explanation could be that there's not enough body resources to grow the muscle. They're all being spent on repairing it. What this all means for Wolverine is that even if he could repair a lot of muscle damage, even very rapidly, that wouldn't necessarily lead to him becoming a huge jacked man. Some studies have even shown that if you eliminate the satellite cells, the cells that actually do the regenerating, the cells that Wolverine would be really good at producing, your muscles can still get bigger.
Okay, all right, all right. Okay, okay.
Yeah. So, because of his healing factor, could Wolverine become the ultimate bodybuilder? Well, I don't think so. Despite what you may have heard at a gym or on the internet, more muscle damage does not directly lead to more muscle mass, even though we know it has to play some role. And muscle cells don't divide like skin cells do, and so Wolverine's main ability to repair and replace cells after a grievous wounding wouldn't lead to crazy swoleness. Although, Wolverine probably would be more naturally jacked than you or me because he has to carry around a very heavy adamantium skeleton his entire life. Because science! There is no greater source of health nonsense than a gym. You walk into a gym, some guy's like, you know what you gotta do? It's 3 reps for 2 minutes, resting for 30 seconds, and then you ingest some bull shark testosterone and some whey protein, organic, and that's the way you... Shut up. There's so few studies that establish anything specific about what is the best approach to be healthy. If anything, it's very generic. It's don't eat a lot of meat or a lot of sugar or a lot of fat, eat a lot of fruits and vegetables, don't smoke, exercise. Everyone else is trying to sell you something. Speaking of which, if you want to get jacked, you can check out... Thank you so much for watching, Frida. Make sure to like and subscribe if you like this video and follow me on social media where I post a bunch of cool science stuff. And you can check out me and Dan Casey on Musquatch, or you can get this show 2 days earlier on Alpha. Subscribe to projectalpha.com and you get a free 30-day trial and me soon.